We start with the first story where controversy is presenting itself at the Thika Level 5 hospital following the mysterious disappearance of an infant born at the facility. The mother insists that she delivered the child alive through the cesarean section, while the health officials claim the child was born dead and disposed of. Our very own reporter Omondi Otieno has the details.
The coming of a newborn brings joy to the world. But in Thika Level 5, things took a different turn after an infant mysteriously disappeared at the facility. While the baby's mother claims she delivered her baby boy safely through cesarean section on November 18 this year, the hospital management dismissed the claim, saying the baby was delivered dead and was disposed of.
Nikisha toka CS, nilitoka na mtoto. Na wakanipeleka kwa maternity ward. Saa huko, nilinyonyesha mtoto wangu. Ikifika saa nane, walimchukua, wakasema kuna vipimo wanataka kumpima.
The grandmother, Felice Tamweni, says they were told to pay 5,000 delivery cost and 1,000 disposal fee to allow her girl to be discharged from the hospital, of which they obliged. Huh? The sorrowful cry of the family demanding to be shown at least the body of the infant seems to have hit a snag.
Mimi naomba serikali inisaidie nimpate hata akiwa amekufa nimuone nimzike. Hivyo tu.
Hospital medical superintendent Jason Ngugi, however, refuted the claims, maintaining that the baby was born dead and that the family was even shown the body.
She was aware of her surrounding. And the baby was shown to her after delivery, and she was able to confirm the outcome being a stillbirth. Where the baby was taken was where we take other stillbirths. Yes, and the mother actually accepted that she paid the disposal fee for the fetus to the hospital.
Takeaway sub-county children officer Lena Mwangi raised concerns over the case, terming it as unfortunate for a baby to get lost in that manner. She called on the police to investigate the matter to ensure the child is accounted for.
The teenage mother and the grandmother are feeling at a loss because they don't know where to go. They are very vulnerable. And my fear is like maybe somebody took advantage of the teenage mother because she was very vulnerable and could not defend herself. It's our prayer that justice would be served in tracing that child.
Act 149 of the Constitution under Section 29 provides that when a medical practitioner certifies the death of a person, he shall complete a death registration form in form number 6 in triplicate and shall issue the original and duplicate to the next of kin of the deceased person, who shall take them to the registrar to obtain a permit to dispose of the body under Section 19 of the same Act. This seems not to be the case at Thika Level 5 Hospital, calling for more legal action. For KUTV News, I'm Omondi Otieno.